Hello students, this is your economics teacher Ayyanar. I hope you are well and utilizing the time wisely.
Today you are going to revise chapter 5 monetary economics and chapter 6 banking. 1 marks, 2 marks and 3 marks. Student, watch this video very carefully till the end. First, we will revise chapter 5 and chapter 6 1 marks. Chapter 5 1 marks. Question number 1. The RBI headquarter is located at Mumbai. Question number 2. Money is the most liquid of all assets. Question number 3. Paper currency system is managed by the Central Monetary Authority. Question number 4. The basic distinction between M1 and M2 is with regard to time deposits of bank. Question number 5. Irving Fisher's quantity theory of money was popularized in 1911. Question number 6. MV stands for supply of legal tender money. Question number 7. Inflation means prices are rising. Question number 8. Dash inflation results in a serious depreciation of the value of money, IPER. Question number 9. Dash inflation occurs when general price of commodities increases due to increase in production cost such as wages and raw materials, cost push. Question number 10. During inflation, who are the gainers? Debtors. Question number 11. Dash is a decrease in the rate of inflation. Disinflation. Question number 12. Stagflation combines the rate of inflation with stagnation. Question number 13. The study of alternating facilitations in business activity is referred to in economics as trade cycle. Question number 14. During depression, the level of economic activity become extremely low. Question number 15. Money can be anything that is generally acceptable as a means of exchange and that the same time act as a measure and a store of value. This definition was given by Crowther. Question number 16. Debit card is an example of plastic money. Question number 17. Fisher quantity theory of money is based on the essential functions of money as medium of exchange. Question number 18. V in MV is equal to PT. Equation stands for velocity of circulation of money. Question number 19. When prices rises slowly, we call it mild inflation. Question number 20. Dash inflation is in no way dangerous to the economy. Gripping inflation. Next, chapter 6, 1 mark. Question number 1. A bank is a financial institution. Question number 2. A commercial bank is an institution that provides services both A and B. Question number 3. The functions of commercial banks are broadly classified into A, B and C. Question number 4. Bank credit refers to bank's loan and advances. Question number 5. Credit creation means multiplications of loans and advances. Question number 6. NBFI does not have banking license. Question number 7. Central bank is dash authority of any country monetary. Question number 8. Who will act as the banker to the government of India, RBI? Question number 9. Lender of the last resort is one of the functions of central bank. Question number 10. Bank rate means rediscounting the first class securities. Question number 11. Moral suasion refers to persuasion. Question number 13. ARDC started functioning from July 1st, 1963. Nabharat was set up in July 1982. Question number 15. Exim Bank was established in March 1982. Question number 15. 2016 demonetization of currency includes denomination of rupees 500 and rupees 1000. Secondly, you are going to revise chapter 5 and chapter 6, 2 marks. Question number 1. Define money. Money is what money does, Walker. Money can be anything that is generally acceptable as a means of exchange and at the same time act as a measures and a store of value, Crowther. Question number 2. What is commodity money? Under the border system, buyers and sellers of commodities had to face a number of difficulties. Surplus goods were exchanged for money, which in turn was exchanged for other needed goods. Goods like furs, skins, salt, rice, wheat, wooden stills, weapon, etc. were commonly used as money. Question number 3. What is gold standard? Gold standard is a system in which the value of the monetary units or the standard currency is directly linked with gold. The monetary unit is defined in terms of a certain weight of gold. The purchasing power of a unit of money is maintained to the value of fixed weight of gold. Question number 4. What is plastic money? Give example. Plastic money is one of the money evolved from the financial products. Plastic money is an alternative to the cash or standard money. Plastic money is a term that is used predominantly in reference to the hard plastic cards used every day in place of actual bank notes. Plastic money can come for many different forms, such as cash cards, credit cards, debit cards, prepaid cash cards, store cards, forex card and smart cards. Question number 5. Define inflation. Inflation is a consistent and appreciable rise in the general price level. In other words, inflation is the rate at which the general price level for the goods and services is rising, and consequently the purchasing power of currency is falling. Question number 6. What is stagflation? Stagflation, the coexistence of a high rate of unemployment and inflation, derived from stagnation and inflation. Question number 7. What is border? Border means the exchange of one goods for another without the use of money. Question number 8. Define commercial bank. Commercial bank, these are the institution that makes short-term loans to business and in the process creates money. Question number 9. What is credit creation? It means the multiplication of loans and advances. Commercial banks receives deposits from the public and use these deposits to give loans. Question number 10. Define central bank. Central bank is an institution that manages a state currency, money supply and interest rate. Central banks also usually oversee the commercial banking system. Question number 11. Distinguish between CRR and SLR. CRR, cash reserve ratio. Banks are required to hold a certain proportion of their deposits in the form of cash with RBI. This is known as CRR. SLR, statutory liquidity ratio. It is the amount which a bank has to maintain in the form of cash, gold or approved securities. Question number 12. Write the meaning of open market operation. Open market operations. In narrow sense, the central bank starts the purchase and sale of government securities in the money markets. In broad sense, the central bank purchases and sells not only government securities but also other proper eligible securities like bills and securities of private concerns. When the banks and the private individuals purchase these securities, they have to make payments for these securities to the central bank. Question number 13. What is rationing of credit? Rationing of credit. This is the oldest method of credit control. Rationing of credit as an instrument of credit control was first used by the Bank of England by the end of the 18th century. It aims to control and regulate the purpose for which credit is granted by commercial banks. It is generally of two types. First, the variable portfolio ceilings. It refers to the system by which the central bank fixes ceiling or maximum amount of loans and advances for every commercial bank. Second, the variable capital assets ratio. It refers to the system by which the central bank fixes the ratio which the capital of the commercial bank should have to the total assets of the bank. Question number 14. Mention the functions of agricultural credit departments. Functions of agricultural credit departments. To maintain and export staff to study all the questions on agricultural credits. Second, to provide expert advice to central and state government, state cooperative banks and other banking activities. Third, to finance the rural sector through eligible institution engaged in the business of agricultural credits and to coordinate their activities. Last, you are going to revise chapter 5 and chapter 6, 3 marks. First, chapter 5, 3 marks. Question number 1. Write a note on metallic money. After the border system and commodity money system, modern money system evolved. Among these, metallic standard is the premier one. Under metallic standard, some kinds of metal, either gold or silver, is used to determine the standard value of money and currency. Standard coins made out of the metal are the principal coins used under the metallic standard. These standard coins are full-bodied or full-weighted legal tender. Their face value is equal to their intrinsic metal value. Question number 2. What is money supply? Money supply means the total amount of money in an economy. It refers to the amount of money which is in circulation in an economy at a given point of time. Money supply plays a crucial role in the determinations of price level and interest rate. Money supply viewed at a given point of time is a stock and over a period of time it is a flow. Question number 3. What are the determinants of money supply in India? There are 4 determinants of money supply in India. First, currency deposit ratio, CDR. It is the ratio of money held by the public in currency to that they hold in the bank deposit. Second, reserve deposit ratio, RDR. Reserve money consists of 2 things. First, vault cash in banks and deposits of commercial banks with RBI. Third, cash reserve ratio, CRR. It is the fraction of the deposits the banks must keep with RBI. Fourth, statutory liquidity ratio, SLR. It is the fraction of the total demand and time deposits of the commercial banks in the form of a specified liquid asset. Question number 4. State the Cambridge equations of value of money. Cambridge approach or cash balance approach. The value of money deals with Marshall equations. The Marshall equation is expressed as M is equal to KPY, where M is the quantity of money, Y is the aggregate real income of the community, P is the purchasing power of money, K is the fractions of the real income which is the public desires to hold in the form of money. Thus, the price level P is equal to M by KY or the value of money, the reciprocal of price level is 1 by P is equal to KY by M. The value of money in terms of this equation can be found out by dividing the total quantity of goods which the public desires to hold out of the total income by the total supply of money. According to Marshall equation, the value of money is influenced not only by changes in M but also by changes in K. Question number 5. Write the types of inflation. There are 4 types of inflation. First, gripping inflation. Second, walking inflation. Third, running inflation. Fourth, galloping inflation or hyperinflation. First, gripping inflation. Gripping inflation is a slow moving and very mild. The rise in the price will not be perceptible but spread over a long period. Second, walking inflation. When prices rises moderately and the annual inflation rate is a single digit. Third, running inflation. When prices rise rapidly like the running of a horse at a rate of speed of 10% up to 20% per annum. Fourth, galloping inflation or runaway inflation. Galloping inflation or hyperinflation or runaway inflation points it out to unmeaningably high inflation rates that run into 2 or 3 digits. Question number 6. Explain demand pull and cost push inflation. First, demand pull inflation. Demand and supply plays a crucial role in deciding the inflation level in the society at all points of times. For instance, if the demand is high for a product and supply is low, the price of the product increases. Second, cost to push inflation. When the cost of raw material and other inputs rises, inflation results. Increase in wages paid to labor also leads to inflation. Question number 7. Explain disinflation. Disinflation is the slowing down the rate of inflation by controlling the amount of credit like bank loan, higher purchase available to consumers without causing more unemployment. Disinflation may be defined as the process of reversing inflation without creating unemployment or reducing output in the economy. Question number 8. Give you a brief note on NBFI. A non-banking financial institution, NBFI, or non-bank financial company, NBFC, is a financial institution that does not have a full banking license or it is not supervised by the Central Bank or Reserve Bank of India. The NBFIs do not carry on pure banking business, but they will carry on other financial transactions. They receive deposits and give loans. They mobilize people's savings and use the funds to finance expenditure on investment activities. In short, there are institutional which undertake borrowing and lending. They operate in both the money and capital markets. NBFIs can be broadly classified into two categories, like stock exchange and second, other financial institution. Under the latter category comes finance companies, finance corporation, SIT funds, building societies, issue houses, investment trust and unit trust and insurance companies. Question number 9. Bring out the methods of credit control. There are two methods of credit control. First, general or quantitative credit control. Second, selective or qualitative credit control. Quantitative credit control can be classified into three major heads. First, bank rate. Second, open market operation. Third, variable cash reserve ratio. Selective or qualitative credit control can be classified into six major types. First, rationing of credit. Second, direct action. Third, moral suasion. Fourth, publicity. Fifth, regulations of consumer credit. Sixth, marginal requirements. Question number 10. What are the functions of NABARD? There are some important major functions of NABARD. So, first function. NABARD act as the refinancing institution for all kinds of production and investment credit to agriculture, small scale industries, cottage and village industries, handicrafts and rural crafts and real artisans and all other economic activities with a view to promoting integrated rural development. Second, it provides a short term, medium term and long term credit to state cooperative banks, regional rural banks, land development banks and other financial institutions approved by Reserve Bank of India. Third, NABARD gives long-term loans to the state government to enable them to subscribe to the share capital of cooperative credit societies. Fourth, NABARD gives long-term loans to any institution approved by the central governments or contribute to the share capital or invest in securities of any institution concerned with agriculture and rural development. Fifth, NABARD has the responsibility of coordinating the activities of central and state governments, the Planning Commission, now Nidhi Aayog, and other all India and state level institutions entrusted with the development of small scale industries, village and cottage industries, rural crafts industries in the tiny and decentralized sector, etc. Sixth, it has the responsibility to inspect RRB and cooperative banks other than primary cooperative societies. Seventh, it maintains a research and development fund to promote research in agricultural and rural development. Students, answer any three major functions. Question number 11. Specify the functions of IFCA. IFCA provides assistance to the industrial concern in the following ways. First, long-term loans both in rupees and foreign currencies. Second, underwriting of equity preferences and debentures issues. Third, subscribing to equity preference and debentures issues. Fourth, guaranteeing the deferred payments in respect of machinery imported from abroad or purchased in India. And fifth, guaranteeing of loans raised in foreign currency from foreign financial institution. That's all for today. We will continue in the next class. Freeze the assignment by clicking the link below.